Hi, this is a quick video to cover how to manage your data in WaveMaker. Now, WaveMaker works with a local database on the device you're using. This means that saving can be done instantly. It means that if you lose an internet connection, it doesn't break. You literally have a local copy at all times. One of the problems with this is you can have multiple copies on different devices. You could be working on your phone, you could be working on your desktop, you can't easily share them. So I rigged up a way of doing that for you, which you can do with importing and exporting the entire database, or even importing and exporting a specific project file. My personal favorite way of doing it is to connect to Google Drive, which is the most easiest, most straightforward way of doing it for me. Is you click on the button, it will ask for your permission. You click OK, it'll give permission for you to write a file to Google Drive, and then you literally have a copy on the Google Drive that you can synchronize up to and synchronize down from. This is done manually so that you don't accidentally overwrite work on one machine whilst working on another. If you pick up your phone, for example, and make a change, it won't delete the work on your computer until you're absolutely ready to go, actually, no, I think I will make that change now. So I'm going to create a new project, and I'm going to call it test. And I get straight into the project. And I'll just quickly jump back to the main menu, and I should have test in my list. If I manage my projects, I can synchronize up to Google Drive, and up it goes. Now, if I delete my local database, that's it cleared out. But what I can do is assume I've gone onto a new device. I can sign into Google Drive again on the new device and click synchronize down, and it will pull the data from Google Drive and load it into this machine, and you're good to go. You can avoid using Google Drive by simply downloading a copy of the database, which will create a backup file in your downloads folder. That is date stamped, so you'll always know which one is the latest. It has a date as part of the file name. You can upload another one of those by clicking the upload button. And you can export an individual project from the export options once you're in a project. And if you've got one that way, so say you want to give a project to a friend or just move one file to a new device, you can export that project, email it over, and import it again here. I think I do have one sitting here, and let's have a look. That, I believe, is one, so I'll do that. And it loads in the entire project as is. And that's it. At the moment, the file created on your Google Drive will also have the advantage that it will be versioned by Google Drive. They'll keep previous historical versions. So if you, for example, accidentally delete everything and upload to Google Drive, you can go onto Google Drive, find a previous version, and switch it to that one so that you can just download from that version again. So it's a little bit of control and a bit of safety by using Google Drive. Now, I hope you enjoy using WaveMaker. WaveMaker is free software, and we're continuing to develop it constantly. However, if you want to support me in this, you can become a patron, and there are links below.